After independence, the objectives of Indian food policy was basically to ensure, first of all, the food security. Because remember, after 200 years of the British rule, India's food security was completely destroyed. One way to look at the British rule or the colonial rule is that there were 200 years of famine and hunger and mass starvation. So our first priority was to build food security so that, you know, we have enough food grains available in India that we do not have famines. Second was to ensure that the farmers get enough income from their farming activities, because that was the core of the India's economy at that time. And we really wanted our farmers to have high income because so they can drive up the Indian economic growth rate. And the third was that people or the masses get access to the food grains at a cheaper rate. Now, these three objectives are very good in themselves, but there's a problem. The problem is that we cannot achieve all three of them simultaneously. Think of it in this way. If you're increasing the higher food grains production, if the supply is increasing in the economy, the prices is definitely going to fall. When the prices of the food grains is falling, then the incomes of the farmers will get affected. You know, they will also decline. And if in order to ensure that the farmers' income remain higher, we artificially increase the prices, the consumers will get hurt via higher inflation. Now, and this is the problem we have been trying to solve, and we have never been able to solve, because all these three objectives are contradictory to each other, in the sense that they're not negatively contradictory, but they're impossible to achieve simultaneously. So what we did in the 1960s, basically, when we had two wars, we had two major famines in India, it became very clear that we have to do something about the food security in India.